we write to these two men and tell them that this was an inbreaking of God's kingdom, an inbreaking of the world as it can be, the world as it ought to be. Let's tell them. So they wrote, the whole class, signed the letter. You don't know who we are. We're a bunch of Methodists trying to learn to be pastors, but we want to tell you that what you said yesterday for us has great meaning. It means that this world is being changed. This world is being redeemed. This world is becoming what we theologians call the kingdom of God. And we want to thank you for pointing the way. A week later, the students got a reply from both of these men. And it wasn't just a staff letter, you know, the kind they keep, slot a name in, thank you for writing, blah, blah, blah. This was a personal letter. And you could tell from both letters that these men never got thanked very much for anything. They got criticized a lot. But to actually receive a letter that said, this means so much in terms of what Christians believe is the coming kingdom of God. Thank you. Well, periodically I clean out my stuff. I always regret doing so because I always throw away something I didn't mean to throw away. And that letter, I'm afraid, was one of them. So I'm telling you this by memory. But I've never forgotten it. Now, just suppose every leader of every nation was thanked once a week instead of criticized. I wonder how much closer that would bring us to the kingdom of God. Every time we see an injustice, we should speak out against it. But every time we see God's justice being done, we should speak for it. And if you want the ratio, I would put it 20 to 1. Every time we have to speak out against injustice, let's find 20 occasions we can affirm justice. Be good news, wouldn't it? Be very good news. Folks, it's been entrusted to us, the church. What a mixed bunch we are. And yet we've been entrusted with the greatest news this planet could ever receive. Let's find ways of acting responsibly. And this is not a reactive choice. It is a proactive choice. The first choice we have is not to resist grace. The second choice we have is to take grace into the world with authority, with conviction, with courage, and with energy, and above all, with love. We sometimes think that living the Christian life is enough. No, it's not. We must live the Christian life, but we also have a message to take to the world. And the message is, the kingdom of God is coming on earth as in heaven. And therefore, our message to you in the world is, get ready. It is coming. Quit resisting it. Because God loves you. God loves this planet, and Jesus Christ has sent us to do that. So, let's do it.
Right, church, shall we all rise? Indeed, we want to respond to the call to take grace into the world, to take grace into the places where God has placed us. And so we want to just sing this last song to declare that we will speak out, we will stand up, we'll defend the poor and the needy, we'll lift up the weak in the name of Jesus.
I will speak out for those who have no voices. I will stand up for the rights of all the oppressed. I will speak.